What is up, everybody? Welcome to this week's Jesse Spec YouTube video. This week, we dive into the tuning of the 2ZZ engine on my Dynapack Dyno. I'm warning you, there will be a few problems on the way. So anyway, without further ado, let's dive right into it. Join me. What is up, everybody? Welcome back to the warehouse. So here you can see the Dynapack is already on and running. The MR2 is right here. So let's get into putting the car on the Dynapack dyno and start the tuning process. Okay, first let's turn on the dyno fan. This thing is amazing. It can send up to 165 kilometers per hour wind speed, which makes it an absolute beast regarding airflow, which is really important when you tune a car on a dyno to get something as realistic as possible. The dodgy gray cable that you see sticking out of the engine bay here is nothing other actually than an intake temp sensor that is connected to my Dynapack dyno, so I can actually measure what is the temperature inside the engine bay. On top of that, I also installed on the exhaust manifold an AFR sensor that is also connected to my dyno, so I can get all the readings inside the dyno, which will make it much easier to set up the car. An interesting point about Dynapack dynos is many people think it takes super long to put a car on the dyno, on the Dynapack dyno, but actually, as you will be seeing here, I sped the video speed up for you, but it actually only takes roughly 15 minutes to put the car on the dyno, which is very similar to the regular roller dynos, but you have the huge advantage of not having any wheel friction on the rollers and no differences in strapping pressure onto the rollers, which gives you really repeatable results when you are measuring your power and torque figures. You know, basically a strapped car on a roller dyno, if you do not strap it exactly the same thing, it will influence your power figures. And that is also something that I never really liked about those kind of dynos. This is why I decided to go with Dynapack. And also, I don't think I need to explain to you why I like Dynapack dynos. It's such a tight workshop space that I have currently, so this is why I decided to go for the hub dyno that is very flexible and that can be put aside no problem once the car is tuned. Okay, the car is on the dyno now, as you can see behind me here. Next step will be to start running it in, checking idle, making sure that everything is running correctly, and then I will start adjusting the fuel tables. That's the first step.
This green little box that you see here is my knock detection system. It is made basically by functioning and measuring frequencies with an external knock sensor, an independent one that you screw onto the engine block, ideally. That's what I did. I can also hook up earphones on top of that to get also the audio footage into it. And what I like about that little machine is it not only has audio data that you can hear and listen to, but you also have graphical illustrations that show you what the knock is doing, and it also flashes in case you get knocked, so that can sort of tell you to back off the car when you are on the dyno and doing a run, for example. Without going into too much detail, but what I like to do is do steady state tuning cell by cell in order to get the AFRs right. And I of course have a very conservative ignition table to make sure I don't run into knock. And even in that case, I use my knock detection system to make sure I don't get any knock whatsoever. Here you see I put my earphones in. That is basically so I can listen to knock while I'm looking at my screen and I don't need to focus on the screen of the knock detection system, and I can still listen. could hear probably at 4,700 RPM, I ran into the same misfire that I had on the road, and I need to check what it is because it's preventing me from tuning the car. The little red dots that you see on my screen there is the image trace function on my tuning program that allows me to see where the car runs and in which cells so I can make adjustments.
So the first culprit I thought it would be my AFR sensor, because it was doing this weird misfiring always at the same RPM, 4,700 on the dot. I could see it on the dyno with a few runs. So it doesn't look that dirty. So I anyway gave it a clean and I will be putting it back into the car.
Another known culprit are the ignition coils. Thanks to the guys on the Mr2 Spyder Facebook page, they told me to check my ignition coils, and that's what I did. And look at this guy. Cylinder one has a nice crack on it. I don't know if you can see it. Let's take a look here. Voila, here you can see it. You can just see the crack. And this is ignition coil number two. Look at this one, totally cracked, like three huge cracks on it. It's very easy to understand that probably the sparks were coming out through these large cracks. So this is definitely something that I should have seen when I was rebuilding the engine. And yeah, sometimes we make stupid mistakes.
And this is one of them. Bravo, Jesse.
All right, we're back in the office. So as you see, things didn't go as planned today. It pisses me off because I always tell my customers or my friends that go on my dyno for tuning, make sure to check everything before you do it, because it gets expensive when you go on the dyno and something breaks along the way or isn't working perfectly. Of course, it's my dyno, so I'm just losing time basically. But so what happened is I have two of my ignition coils that are cracked, really severely cracked. So probably the spark would go out at that part and would create the misfire at 4,700-ish RPM. I would lose power significantly, and I thought it was the airflow meter, so I cleaned it. But actually, when I looked at my ignition coils, I realized they were totally destroyed. So now I got two brand new ones from Toyota. So as you can see here, my friend from Toyota hooked me up with some of these. He had some left in his inventory. So here, brand new one. Ready to go. I will be installing them and I will be trying giving the tuning another try this week, and I will be uploading another video at the end, as I should, on Friday instead of being a day late like this time. I'm sorry for everybody who was waiting for the video. I'm really taking this seriously. Consistency is the game here, so sorry for the delay. And anyway, I'm a bit pissed off because I was hoping to get most of the tuning done last time and I couldn't, so sorry about that. And anyway, I'll keep at it. And so in any case, all of you guys who like, subscribed, and watch all my videos, I really thank you. It's really encouraging and inspiring for me to see how many people actually like and think my videos are useful. We're getting close to the 600 subscriber mark, and that is really thanks to all of you guys. I really want to thank you for that.
And all the 70% of my viewers who are not subscribed, please subscribe. It would help me a lot.
Anyway, I know it's annoying. Everybody always asks that, but I tell you, if you like our content, we do this all for free. You know, I'm not sponsored. I'm not getting paid to do these videos. I'm doing it purely out of passion for Toyotas and cars. So if you can recognize yourself in me by watching my videos, or you like this kind of content, make sure if you subscribe, it's always a good way to show that you appreciate the work that is put behind all this. And I'm doing this next to my job, next to my running my business. So it's really a hobby and I really like doing it, but the more people support it, the easier it will be for me. I'm sorry to push you guys to subscribe, but that's just how it works on YouTube. If you want people to grow your channel and evolve, that's you have to do it. And all you guys who already did, thanks a million. I really appreciate your support. And without further ado, I'm gonna stop blabbering and I will see you next week and look forward to it, because I'm pretty sure there will be some numbers from the dyno figures and everything, and I hope that I can squeeze the power out of it that I'm actually hoping. So thank you very much for watching this week's video, and I will see you next week.
Peace.